Hello, my name is Erika Romein. I work for the Department of Geoinformation Science and Remote Sensing at Wageningen University. Together with my colleague Nikki De C, I have developed this lecture in the series of the REDD Plus training materials by GOFC-GOLD, Wageningen University and the World Bank. With this lecture, you will learn about national data organization and management in the context of MRV for REDD Plus. Having a clear and stable institutional setup is a very important start for countries when they are engaged in the REDD Plus process and want to estimate and report on greenhouse gas emissions and removals from REDD Plus activities. Different agencies have different roles and responsibilities for organizing and managing the data. When collecting and managing these data, the IPCC reporting principles need to be taken into account. At the end of this lecture, you will be able to understand all these different aspects that are related to national data organization and management. This slide shows some background reading materials related to the topic. They are all freely available and you can find them online. The lecture consists of two parts. In the first part, I will explain the importance and the different aspects of having an institutional framework. In the second part, I will elaborate on data management. I will give some practical examples and explain the steps in data management that are important when preparing a national greenhouse gas inventory. Clear and stable institutional arrangements and consistent political support are important enabling factors for continuous improvement in national forest monitoring for REDD Plus in non-Annex 1 countries. This slide shows some of the reasons why it is important to have an institutional framework for MRV and for data management. An institutional framework allows different actors and sectors to work together. However, in this framework, the different roles and responsibilities of the different agencies and stakeholders need to be clearly defined. This will improve coordination among ministries, subnational governments, and other agencies, and it will also improve efficiency and long-term sustainability and the decision-making process. An institutional framework also allows countries to document and archive data in a clear and transparent manner. In this way, the country will build up institutional memory. With clear documentation and archiving of the data, other parties will understand the nature of the data and also know who is providing the data. Some more benefits of institutional arrangements are listed here on the slide. This slide lists the requirements for an institutional framework for MRV of REDD Plus activities. As mentioned before, high-level national coordination is essential. Firstly, it is needed to link the measurement and reporting activities to the national REDD Plus policies, to ensure monitoring is done at the right locations. And secondly, it is needed to specify and oversee roles and responsibilities. Furthermore, there is the need for measurement and monitoring protocols and technical units to handle the data. There is also a need for reporting units to produce national estimates for international reporting to the UNFCCC. And an independent verification framework is needed to verify long-term effectiveness of REDD Plus actions. Following the requirements as mentioned in the previous slide, this slide sums up the recommended institutions for MRV. A country should consider setting up these institutions as a minimum and should clearly define their roles and responsibilities. In the next section, we will talk about the EPA templates, which can be very useful for summarizing the international institutional arrangements that are needed. I won't go into detail about the different options for institutional arrangements. However, the institutional arrangements that a country can choose, they highly depend on the national circumstances. More about these options can be read in the reference on this slide. The full reference can be found at the end of the lecture. This slide shows an example of the institutional arrangements that India made. The Ministry of Environment and Forests is responsible for the overall coordination of the preparation of greenhouse gases estimation for the LULUCF sector. There are many other institutes involved, and they all have clear roles and responsibilities. For example, the National Remote Sensing Center, or NRSC, in this figure here, provides Earth observation data to users. Its role in the greenhouse gas inventory preparation is to prepare the land use map for cropland, grassland, settlements, and other land, and to estimate changes in land use. It also provides the forest data to the Forest Survey of India, the FSI. The Forest Survey of India performs forest and tree cover assessments, which includes preparing the forest land use map, estimating changes in forest cover, estimating area of biomass burning, determination of above ground biomass, below ground biomass, and soil carbon, and estimation of carbon stock change from land use changes in forests and from biomass burning. All the different institutes meet at a regular basis. We end this part of the lecture with summarizing the recommendations for institutional arrangements. High-level commitment from the government is important, as well as involving all relevant agencies. To ensure long-term commitment, it is important to have long-term financial support. Capacity building and coordination need to be done at national level, as well as at subnational level. And lastly, a policy framework is needed to enable data sharing and communication, amongst others. A data management system will be a vital part of this, as will be explained in the second part of the lecture. Okay, let's continue with the second part of this lecture. This part deals with practical sides of data management and includes some examples of forest and land use information systems and national spatial data networks. I will explain the main topics and messages of each slide. This part of the presentation includes detailed slide notes, which you can read afterwards and which will give you more background information. In the previous section, we talked about the importance of having a clear and stable institutional setup. It is equally important for countries to organize their data in a clear and transparent way, and therefore to develop a data management system. When a country has a well-organized data management system, ministries, subnational governments, and other agencies will have a better overview of all available data and will also have easy access to these data. This supports countries
to formulate their climate change mitigation policies and improves the decision-making process. A data management system will not only provide essential data, but will also improve coordination among the different parties involved. Data integration, data access, and data sharing are important aspects of a data management system. This slide shows a conceptual figure of a spatial data infrastructure, or SDI. An SDI can be seen as a framework that facilitates and coordinates the exchange and sharing of spatial data. The aim of an SDI is to contact people with the right data. It allows data sharing between and within organizations, states, or countries. The framework includes policies, standards, and access networks. For MRV of REDD Plus, there is a need for a data management system that integrates forest and land use data. Such a system can be represented by a FLUIS, a Forest and Land Use Information System. Important components of such a system are a data repository for storing spatial data, non-spatial data and metadata, the people who manage the data, such as system managers and technicians, and people who use the data. These are called the end users. Policy framework for improving data management, protocols and standards for data collection and protocols for data sharing, technology for managing and maintaining the data management system. This system helps to improve cross-sectoral coordination, communication and data integration. The combined data will help to better understand the drivers of forest and land use change. This in turn enables better informed decision making and land use planning. This figure shows how data can flow from data collectors to end users. Data are collected by regional governments, local governments, and through community forest monitoring. Then the data are transferred to national agencies for integration. The national agencies send data to the FLUIS for further integration and aggregation. From this central platform, the data can be accessed by the end users, which could be government staff, civil society groups, research institutes, and the general public. They in turn may also contribute data to the FLUIS. Examples of a FLUIS are Cameroon's Interactive Forest Atlas and Indonesia's One Map Policy. These are both web-based portals with built-in GIS servers where you can view different available maps. Agencies can use these portals to share maps, geodatabases, and tools. This is a great support for forest management and land use planning. This slide shows some more examples of national spatial data systems. It shows the data flow from the data collectors to the end users. The reference at the end of the lecture provides a full explanation of the agencies that are involved and what their roles and responsibilities are. The estimation and reporting of greenhouse gases under the UNFCCC should comply with the 5 general reporting principles from the IPCC. Therefore, these 5 principles should also be taken into account when collecting and managing data. What are the data management needs for preparing a national greenhouse gases inventory? First, there are some aspects related to data collection and assimilation that need to be taken into account. It is very important to ensure the quality of the data in each phase of the inventory process. Archiving of all relevant data, information and methods is important. Also, explanations, for the selection of data, methods and procedures is essential in order to ensure transparency and to be able to respond to requests for clarification of information on the national inventory. Data assimilation and processing includes processing of the data into a format that can be used for estimation of greenhouse gases emissions and removals. Then the actual emissions and removals can be estimated. It is important to perform uncertainty assessments related to emissions estimates. When a country wants to report carbon emissions and removals, the first thing to do is to organize the MRV data into a reporting format. Module 3.3 gives more information on how to do this. Implementing quality assurance and quality control procedures and verification of the reported data is very important. Finally, a country needs to archive all relevant data, information, methods and explanations. Affluence can be very helpful to do this. Countries need to have sufficient capacity to collect and manage data. Therefore, it might be necessary to train staff on how to collect, process and store the data. Developing standard operation procedures will help to manage data and to compile a greenhouse gases inventory. This includes user-friendly documentation and explanations on how to collect and manage data and how, for example, to perform forest area change assessments and calculate emission factors. Special software, such as ALU software, can also be helpful to guide users through the entire process of conducting a greenhouse gases inventory. As mentioned before, quality assurance and quality control are important aspects of the whole process. Quality control is performed by the inventory development team itself. Quality assurance is performed by people who are not involved in the inventory development process. Quality control procedures need to be implemented for checking the quality of the data included in the greenhouse gases inventory and thereby following the IPCC guidance. This needs to be done for key categories and for individual categories in which significant methodological and/or data revisions have occurred. Quality assurance and quality control helps to improve transparency, consistency, comparability, completeness and accuracy in national greenhouse gases inventories. The Environmental Protection Agency, the EPA, provides templates to document and organize different components of the national inventory system. The templates can help inventory teams in documenting and reporting the methodologies, datasets and assumptions used to estimate emissions and removals from each category. They can also be used as supporting information for national communications to provide transparency on the data and methods used. They also help future inventory teams in preparing future inventory reports. For example, template 3 asks for a description of QA and QC procedures. It helps in constructing the plan to perform quality assurance and quality control and offer step-by-step guidance and checklists for doing this. This slide shows an example for EPA template 2, methods and data documentation. The material includes step-by-step instructions and table templates, where data and methods and other information should be filled in for each of the steps. So, in summary, a good starting point is to have a clear and stable institutional setup. A country should consider setting up the recommended institutions listed here as a minimum and should clearly define their roles and responsibilities. Apart from this, setting up a spatial data infrastructure or a forest and land use information system is essential. Such a system can be used to store, organize, and integrate large amounts of data and has the ability to connect data collectors with end users. Data management includes various steps from collection of data to processing and archiving and the use of a fluid, but also the national system templates from the Environmental Protection Agency can be very helpful for doing this. Thank you for listening. We have come to the end of this lecture. Recommended modules as a follow-up include module 3.2 on developing REDD Plus reference levels, and in particular module 3.3 on reporting REDD Plus performance. This slide and the next slide include references related to this topic. They are available online and you can consult them to read more about national data management and organization.